वेलकम टू बीएससी स्टैटिस्टिक्स स्टूडेंट्स. इन दिस लेसन आई एक्सप्लेन प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ कोवेरियंस. सो नाउ आई राइट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल फॉर्मूला ऑफ कोवेरियंस. कोवेरियंस ऑफ एक्स वाई इट इज डिनोटेड बाय COV ऑफ एक्स कॉमा वाई एंड इज द फॉर्मूला इज गिवन बाय कोवेरियंस ऑफ एक्स वाई इज इक्वल टू एक्सपेक्टेशन ऑफ एक्स माइनस एक्सपेक्टेशन ऑफ एक्स एंड वाई माइनस एक्सपेक्टेशन ऑफ वाई. दिस इज वॉट द फॉर्मूला ऑफ द कोवेरियंस ऑफ एक्स वाई. अनदर फार्मूला इज ऑल्सो आई गिव यू सिंपल फार्मूला एक्सपेक्टेशन ऑफ एक्स वाई माइनस एक्सपेक्टेशन ऑफ एक्स इंटू एक्सपेक्टेशन ऑफ वाई. ओके राइट. नाउ based on this formula, of course we have another formula. I'm not discussing here the what the whatever the formula we use here, I explained here. Now the properties, the first property, property number one, covariance of ax comma by, it is nothing but ab into covariance of x comma y, right? This is property number one I stated. And how the proof? See the part of proof. It's very easy. Covariance of a x comma b y. It is equivalent to the formula. Right? Using the formula, expectation of here x minus expectation of x here a x. So therefore, a x minus expectation of a x. And second variable by minus expectation of by, and in which is equivalent to expectation of ax this one, and you see here expectation of ax is a into expectation of x. So this is ax minus, from the property of expectation of ax is a into expectation of x. And then again by minus expectation of by is b into expectation of y. So answer is equivalent to b. Now expectation of, you take a common a into x minus expectation of x, and if you take common here b into y minus expectation of y. Now if it, you see here, this is a property, expectation of a b into some x minus expectation of x into y minus expectation of y, some the random variable or a function of random variable. Then it is nothing but from the property of expectations, we can take it outside a b into expectation of x minus expectation of x into y minus expectation of y. So this is what the formula at the end we got. So which means it is nothing but a b into, this is the formula of covariance. Covariance of x comma y. Therefore, covariance of ax comma by is nothing but ab into covariance of xy. You understand? This is what the property number one. Now come to the property number two. What is property number two? If you state, for example, in the similar fashion above, covariance of x plus a and y plus b. If you add some constant to the variables x and y, then what is the formula? What is the property? It is covariance of x, y simply, which these two are not affected. So how to prove? Part of proof. Covariance of a x plus a and y plus b, it can be expressed by using the formula expectation of x plus a minus expectation of x plus a. That is the first variable. Second variable, y plus b minus expectation of y plus b. So it is very simple. Is equivalent to be expectation of x plus a minus expectation of x minus expectation of a constant a. That is expectation of a is a minus a. Close this. and y plus b minus expectation of y is expectation of y, and expectation of b is small b, b. So therefore it was finished. Now you see plus a minus a cancelled, plus b minus b is cancelled. Hence it is equivalent to be expectation of x minus expectation of x and y minus expectation of y. What is this? It is equivalent to be covariance of x comma y. It is nothing but covariance of x comma y. So therefore covariance of x plus a y plus b is equal to covariance of x y. Simply a b are not affected, that is nothing but we learn another property, shifting the origin. Okay, shifting the origin. If you add or subtract a quantity, its origin will be shifted, even though covariance is not affected. That is this, that is the meaning here. Okay, and go to third property, property number 3, which is covariance of ax plus b and cy plus d. The constant I have considered a, b, c, d, right? So you see two properties we have completed, covariance of ax and by. This is one property is ab into covariance of xy. Another property is covariance of x plus a, y plus b, which is covariance of xy. Based on these two properties, we can easily specify this. Just we can easily state this property is equal to, what is the answer of this particular property? AC, this one, AC into covariance of xy. Just now we have stated that even though plus, if you added, it will be only it will not be affected, only the values are x and y, covariance of x, y. So therefore I am directly writing the property, and you can do the property, you prove the property. Kindly you do the property. Okay, now covariance of ax plus by and covariance of ax plus by and some cx plus dy, cx plus dy, and what is this property? It will be ac into, you see these two, ac into variance of x plus these two, bd into variance of y plus 2abcd covariance of x comma y. This is what the property, AD plus BC. Yeah. So then it is AD plus BC, not 2ABCD, AD plus BC. A multiplied by X and Y, AD, these two, AD and plus BC, B and C, X and Y. Whenever you multiply with X and Y, you will get covariance terms. So that is what the concept, and I prove it. Okay, fine. So this is AD plus B into BC into covariance of XY. Now I prove this result, property covariance of AX plus BY CX plus DY. It is equivalent to be as usual formula. It is expectation of AX plus BY minus expectation of ax plus by, that is the first variable. Second one, cx plus dy minus expectation of cx plus dy, that is the second variable. This is the second variable. Okay, I close here. Now you expand this. Do the expectations and take the expectations separately. First one, the first term, ax plus by minus expectation of ax. So a into expectation of x minus expectation of by, b into expectation of y. Finish. Similarly, cx plus dy minus expectation of cx, c into expectation of x minus expectation of dy, d into expectation of y. Okay, this is what the second term close is equivalent to be right here. Expectation of whenever you have the terms x, ax, a into expectation of x, take a common a so that you take a you form the values like x minus expectation of x, which gives the formula. So therefore, wherever you have the terms x minus expectation of x, you form like that, and so that it will be very easy. And now you take a common as by and minus b into expectation of y. If you take common b, then y minus expectation of y. This is one term. And again, now cx minus c into expectation of x, c multiplied by x minus expectation of x, and plus dy d into expectation of y. So plus d into y minus expectation of y. So these are the two terms here, two terms here. You have to multiply. I multiply and take expectations so that you can easily understand, right? X minus expectation of x into x minus expectation of x, the whole square. AC, if you take outside the expectations, then it will be AC into expectation of x minus expectation of x, the whole square. That is the first term. So second term, if you multiply with the first term and the second term, here a d x minus expectation of x, y minus expectation of y. Ad I'm taking outside, ad into expectation of x minus expectation of x into y minus expectation of y. This is the another term. Plus, if you multiply with the second term now, b into y minus expectation of y into c into x minus expectation of x. So bc I'm taking outside of expectations, multiplied by expectation of y minus expectation of y, that is into x minus expectation of x, whatever it is, x minus expectation of x into y minus expectation of y. This is plus the last term, second with the second term, that is b into d plus bd. I'm taking outside expectations, and y minus expectation of y minus expectation of y, which means whole square. So expectation of y minus expectation of y, the whole square. Hope you got the result, right? So this is what you see, AC into this term is, this is the formula, expectation of x minus expectation of x whole square is variance of x, plus now you see last term BD into expectation of y minus expectation of y whole square, this is variance of y, plus AD into expectation of x into expectation of x minus expectation of x into y minus expectation of y, expectation of y minus expectation of y into x minus expectation of x. This is covariance of xy. And this AD plus BC. So therefore, plus AD plus BC, both the terms covariance of xy is common. Covariance of xy. So this is what the result, AC into variance of x plus BD into variance of y plus AD plus BC into covariance of xy. That is what the answer for covariance of AX plus BY, CX plus DY, which is nothing but AC into variance of x and BD into variance of y plus AD plus BC into covariance of xy. This is what the fourth property, another property. Like one more property which is left, that is, we do this property. Now, property number 5. What is this? This property is nothing but shifting the origin and scale. Shifting the origin and scale. This, what is the effect of shifting the origin and scale? Covariance. If you take covariance, what is the effect? Effect of shifting the origin and scale on covariance, which means you have to consider u is equal to x minus a by h and v is equal to y minus p by k. Since there are two variables, you have to write invariably consider u and v. In one variable case, that is variance, we have considered only u because there is one variable in variance of x. In the covariance, we have two variables, covariance of x comma y. Therefore, we have considered two variables, u and v, which implies x is equal to a plus hu and y is equal to b plus kv. So, what I write directly, the covariance, I calculate the covariance. Therefore, covariance of x comma y is going to be calculated by expectation of x minus expectation of x and y minus expectation of y. This is what the covariance, in which now you have to go and substitute the values of a plus hu and b plus kv, and you have to calculate covariance of x and y in terms of u and v. That is a plus hu minus expectation of a plus hu. Of course, you know this entire formula with the result of one of the property, but even then we do. And the next one, b plus kv minus expectation of b plus kv, right? This is the second term, right? It is equivalent to b expectation of, now you see here in the first term, a plus hu minus expectation of a is a, minus expectation of hu is h into expectation of, because h is a constant, minus h into expectation of u. Is it clear? And b plus kv, the second term, if you consider, minus expectation of b, it is b, minus expectation of kv, it is k into expectation of v, right? So therefore, this is the term, the next term. Now you see, a will get cancelled, b plus b minus b will get cancelled, and remaining term, if you consider hu minus h into expectation of u, if take a common h into u minus expectation of u, and the next one multiplied by k into, this is one term, the k multiplied by kv, k into expectation of v, k multiplied by v minus expectation of v. Now you see h and k are constant, expectation. So we can take it outside expectation. That is, expectation of ax is equal to a into expectation of x. That is the reason why we are taking outside hk. And expectation of u minus expectation of u and v minus expectation of v. So this is what is this formula? Covariance. It is equivalent to be hk into covariance of, what are the variables? U and V. So, covariance of U and V. Covariance of XY is equal to HK into covariance of UV, which means H and K remains, but A and B are not present. If you see in this formula, A, B are not present, which means covariance is not affected by shifting the origin. Covariance is not affected by shifting the origin. Even though if you shift the origin, if you subtract some value from a group of values, then covariance not changed. For the previous values and the subtracted values or added values, added some particular value. If you take one value, 10, and if you added all to all the numbers, then covariance will be same for the both the series. That is what the explanation. Right, and H and K, if you divide it with a number, scale will be shifted. If you divide with a number, that is, if you shift the scale, then covariance will be affected. Covariance will be changed. That is what this particular property. Hope you understand. Therefore, covariance is independent of shifting the origin, but not on the scale, which means it depends on shifting the scale. Thank you.